What's going on YouTube? It's Cryptic Spoiler back at it again today, and today I'm bringing you a video on how to get a Stasis Fatebringer. Straight to the point, basically all you need to do is farm the Vault of Glass, or whatever weapon you want to get, until you get the Osmosis perk. The perk activates after you throw a grenade. You don't even have to get a kill with it, you just have to throw it. The perk will deactivate if you switch weapons, use your super, get on your sparrow, or die. Any of these things will clear it out and it'll be back to kinetic damage. Now if you change subclasses and the original modifier you put on it is still on there, it'll stay on there. So like say I'm using Void, I throw my grenade, and then I want to use Solar or something, I switch to Solar. It'll still be Void on the hand cannon as long as I didn't clear it, until I clear it, and then I can clear it by switching weapons and throw my Solar grenade and it'll be Solar. It works with all other three modifiers as well, not just Stasis. So it's a great thing for the Nightfalls, because you can run three weapons with three separate modifiers if you so please. Because I know a lot of time there's a bunch of mixed shields in the modifiers for the Nightfall, and it's kind of hard to pop them without the correct elemental damage. Now with Stasis, since there's no Stasis shields yet, it's, or at least as far as I know, I don't get to play too often, but as far as I know, there's no Stasis shields in the game, which renders it basically pointless. Although it would be kind of funny to get killed in Crucible and see that they were using a Fatebringer with the Stasis modifier. That's pretty much the only purpose of it right now. It doesn't slow people and it doesn't freeze people as far as I know. I didn't notice anything. So since there's no shields to pop, it's basically useless unless you just want to have it, but pretty much more or less that's how you get a Stasis Fatebringer. Now like I said, it's definitely more practical to use this on like Solar or Void or Arc, and even if you wanted to, say you wanted to run Solar but you needed Arc and you're really good at not dying, and you're just gonna run the primary whatever it is for most of the time, you can just switch to, I don't even remember what I said, but say Void. Throw your Void grenade down using the hand cannon, like holding it or whatever weapon it is, and then switch to Solar, and it'll still be a Void hand cannon until you clear it. So like say there's one part of the mission that you need Void for, you don't have any Void weapons on, well now you got a Void hand cannon. You can use that, and then if you want you can clear it, use your other guns, whatever you need. But I don't know, I think it's a really useful and really cool and unique perk. It does, in my opinion, kind of has some glitches. I feel like it shouldn't, or I feel like it should clear when you switch subclasses. And I also noticed that if you switch subclasses and it doesn't clear, and you try to throw a grenade from the new subclass, so say I was using Void and I switched to Arc, and I try to throw my Arc grenade down when it still says Void, it won't change it. You have to clear it out first. But yeah, that's pretty much going to do it for this video, guys. It's just a short and sweet little video on how to get the Fatebringer with a Stasis modifier, or any modifier. So, have a good one. I'll see you in the next one. I'm going numb. Myself and your affection. I'm going numb. Losing our perfection. Don't take it lightly. We could die in the moment, lost in slow motion. We could die in the moment. We won't get away this time. No, we wasted all our brighter days. So close your eyes, the storm is coming one last time. Our hope is washed up. I'm watching this.
just came.